For the wrap-up, I will introduce, although it doesn't really need any introduction and was already introduced by Pierre Gramegna a few hours ago. So Nazir Zubairi, as the CEO of the Loft, please, Nazir, wrap-up is for you.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. I mean, I'm going to start by just saying, wow, right? I mean, it's been an incredible morning of speeches. I mean, really meeting the goals here of the vision of the future, Horizon. I often find it interesting how us as human beings, on the most part, when we think of the world as changing, what we're actually doing in our heads is thinking about today and looking backwards. You know, mobile phones, we look at our phone and say, wow, the world is changing. What we actually really mean is the world has changed. But what we've seen today is, and heard from, is a vision of the future. People that look towards what is coming, what is happening, planning for it and acting upon it. And the fact that you're all here is testimony to the fact that I hope most of you want to also be understanding what is coming and acting on it. For us here in Luxembourg, I think that's critical across all sectors. As a quick break there, I think I'll just pause and say thank you to everyone who attended, to you, the audience, but most importantly, our speakers. I've made lots of notes today. I don't think I've made as many notes in any conference I've been to for about 5 years, but it was just fascinating getting all this information. So I think in order, obviously, we had Pierre at the beginning talking and giving his introduction. Thank you very much to Yuri. He's disappeared because I was boring him or he's hungry. He's still here, okay. I can't see, these lights are incredibly bright. To Charles for his talk on renewable energies, to Linda for her forecasts on economics and my answering my question that I had, which I think is fairly pertinent to a lot of people in Luxembourg about financial services, and to Mark to give us some incredible insights on space and what I think I look at when I was listening to this the speech on space is. What incredible things are achieved, and then in our little micro universe of work, and particularly I think sometimes in the world I focus on financial services, the stuff we complain is too difficult. I mean, that really gives you context to think what can be achieved, and that everything is possible. And we should be trying to do as much as possible. And lastly, in terms of speakers, I have to say thank you very much to Sebastian for his fantastic chairmanship. I hope you appreciated it and his inquisitive questions that he gave to the speakers. And very importantly, to Deloitte for organizing such an amazing conference. Thank you, all of you. Luxembourg, and I think we've all heard this, is a small country. And what I find myself repeating time and time again, and I hope I don't bore you with this, that for a country of 500,000 people and a few thousand that commute in every day, what this country has achieved is incredible. It is at the forefront of space exploration, of satellites. Xavier Bettel, the Prime Minister, often talks about owning more land up there than down here, right? What it's achieving in media, I mean, I'm sorry if this is really boring to you, but I find this amazing because all these little bits of things and information are incredible to me. I was driving, taking a shortcut to avoid all the traffic the other day up through Kirchberg, and I went past the RTL building. And it had never occurred to me, you know, watching television in France, Germany, or anywhere, that the L stands for Luxembourg, right? I mean, it's an amazing progress that a country such as Luxembourg has achieved. And obviously in financial services. A critical element of the economy for Luxembourg, accounting for 30% plus of the GDP of this country. A country of 500,000 people that has, with I think about 130,000 working financial services, that has become the largest financial services center in continental Europe, that in a year and a half's time becomes the largest financial services center in the EU, hopefully, right? Well, I don't know if hopefully, because as you can tell, I'm British, so I mean, it's not a particularly wonderful situation, but working here in Luxembourg, there's huge opportunities that have arisen out of it. I mean, what I really want to leave you with is I don't want to delay you from accessing your lunch anymore. We all have the opportunity to think forward. We do think forward, and we need to think forward. And across whatever industry you work in, the criticality here is to act. It's funny, I picked up this random notebook off my desk. You know, you get these things given to you at conferences left, right, and center. And I hadn't really read what was on it. And it's a quote about leadership. And it says, leadership is about being the first, and then you turn it over to act. There are many, many, many forms of leadership and what makes great leadership, but I think that is a critical element. Things are changing. Things are changing very rapidly. We heard about exponential technologies, about the quantum technologies that are coming to fruition. You know, the question about our children, I think about every day. I know Sebastian does as well. I think we all do. What should they be learning? What should they be studying? What is the world of tomorrow going to look like? And as Linda said, we don't really know, right? It's so up in the balance, the change in the middle class. I think I heard one of the most fantastic speeches recently in Egypt by somebody I think you might know, Sean Cleary, who advises also, I think, the World Economic Forum, talking about the instability of where the world is going at the moment, and that we genuinely don't know what's happening. All we know is going to be different. So we need to start thinking and preparing and working towards that different world. Even if we don't, we know that it's an uncertain outcome. There are ways we can prepare for that. Or we are looking at more agility in organizational structures in the way we work. And very critically, importantly, which Yuri highlighted, talking about China, is collaboration. And I'm very proud to say in the year I spent here, and the reason that I'm still here and I enjoy very much what I do, is that collaboration that is so evident in Luxembourg. The way the community comes together is, to me, the core highlight of what this makes this country what it is and what will continue to make it and drive it forward in the future. Collaboration. That's really my last and parting thought. It's that we continue to work together, that we continue to look towards the future, that we continue to make things happen. And for ourselves, for our children, for this country, I think, and for the rest of the world, I hope, in terms of the impact Luxembourg does have and can continue to have, is the critical element. And I look forward to speaking to some of you and some of the speakers, because I found the speeches genuinely fascinating. Thank you all very much.